Okay, that's the first thing. So in this process of understanding that in the race mind that I'm in, and I'm really good at not being involved in it, but I was told this morning that the reason I'm in the race mind is because I need to show you how to get out of it. If I can get out of it, I can take you out. I know the way home. And that was so loudly said to me this morning, is you know the way home. I want to go home, okay? And it's not because of the state of the world. It's not because, you know, I'm nervous or scared or insecure or anything like that. That has nothing to do with it. What I came to the realization of feeling this depression that I was feeling yesterday was because of my lack of connection. Now, I'm connected to people, but there's this point of really feeling that I need to connect more. I was told that I'm not using my voice enough. Even though I'm using it, it's not enough. There's so much more to say. There's so much more to do. Today, I want to talk about being out of alignment, and what it refers to is where your thoughts, actions, and feelings are not in harmony with your true self or your higher purpose. It often feels like something is off, even if you can't pinpoint exactly what it is. When you're in alignment, your life flows more smoothly and you feel a deeper sense of inner peace and purpose. So some of the signs of being out of alignment is chronic stress and fatigue. You're always feeling overwhelmed, exhausted, anxious, and even without a clear cause. You feel stuck, and you may find it difficult to move forward in life or feel trapped in certain situations, whether it's a job, relationship, or a routine. Lack of joy and fulfillment. You might feel disconnected from what you're doing or that your actions no longer bring happiness and meaning. Inner conflict. You feel torn between what you're doing and what you know deep down is right for you. Physical discomfort. Headaches, tension, and other unexplainable physical symptoms may manifest as the body often mirrors the state of your mind. Disconnection from your intuition. You may ignore your gut feelings or have difficulty hearing your inner voice, leading to poor decisions. Neglecting self-care. Prioritizing external pressures over personal well-being is a key sign of misalignment. I want to talk about each one of these a little bit more. And even though I know I'm not out of alignment, I can still feel all of these. And I have been doing, I believe I'm in the race mind somehow. And normally I know how to disconnect from the race mind. And that's not what's happening right now for me. And I think part of what's going on, and I can say that I'm not feeling stressed or fatigued. I sometimes feel stuck. I have been feeling a little depressed. Like yesterday, I talked to Sal about it and said, I'm just feeling depressed. And I identified a lot of this, and I'm going to go into that more. I don't think I'm really having an inner conflict, but I'm seeing more about myself. I'm not having any physical discomfort. I think that I'm just connected from my intuition, but I also know that I'm not, and I'll explain that. And then neglecting self-care, not really doing that either. But sometimes we can take just what we're feeling inside and say we're out of alignment. Now, that may or may not be true, but on a whole, it's not necessarily that. Because what I've observed in the last week, I think I've been feeling a lot of this, that there's a lot of changes that are going on in the world. I know there's a lot of people that are very sick and tired of the political arena right now. We're tired of what's going on. We're nervous. We're apprehensive about the state of the world and our future. I don't think any of us are really happy with the candidates that we have. What's worse, Trump or Harris? It's who's the lesser of the two evils? I know that's where a lot of people are probably going. My only quick concern is that I hope that each and every one of you really sits down and studies them and not get caught up in the rhetoric or the lies or the bullshit or anything else that's going on out there. Really go into the heart of you and figure out who do you think will serve you. Okay, that's the first thing. So in this process of understanding that in the race mind that I'm in, and I'm really good at not being involved in it, but I was told this morning that the reason I'm in the race mind is because I need to show you how to get out of it. If I can get out of it, I can take you out. I know the way home. And that was so loudly said to me this morning, is you know the way home. I want to go home, okay? And it's not because of the state of the world. It's not because, you know, I'm nervous or scared or insecure or anything like that. That has nothing to do with it. What I came to the realization of feeling this depression that I was feeling yesterday was because of my lack of connection. Now, I'm connected to people, but there's this point of really feeling that I need to connect more. I was told that I'm not using my voice enough. Even though I'm using it, it's not enough. There's so much more to say. There's so much more to do. And that's what I was getting. So, of course, I'm not disconnected from my intuition. I am hearing it, but what they did is they stepped back because this is for me to learn. This is for me to understand. Now, there's something to be said in our struggles, within our conflict, within going inside of ourselves, facing the dark night of the soul, that type of thing. I discovered yesterday as well that the dark night isn't as dark because I've brought so much light and illumination within. I'm understanding the origin of me, the origin of our world, the origin of God, all of that. I understand that because of what I'm reading right now, and I'm remembering it. And it's not like I read these books in 1984. What I felt in 1984 in the second book that I'm now in of the seven book series is the same thing. Now, when I get to further down in the series where I knew that I had some conflict, we'll see if there's an evolution there. But I know that these books are true. It makes sense. I was there. I remember. It's like I remember these things. And it's so far-fetched on so many levels of this book's right use of will. But it's also stirring things up because when I felt that need to go home, another thing that showed up was my suicidal tendencies when I was 17 years old. And I saw it as a pattern. And I didn't realize that I was still holding on to that, or I still had emotion tied around that, because I thought I had resolved all of that by the time I was 30, when I no longer felt suicidal. So I realized that this was a habit. The other thing that I realized during that process is I needed to just look at it, acknowledge it, and release it. And the reason I was suicidal, aside from not wanting to have my parents' life and not knowing my place in the world and not knowing the trauma that I was under and not knowing the abuse or anything else, because I was literally, I was out of my body and I did not know that then. But the reason I wanted to leave was because I wanted to go home. I wanted to be in the love vibration. I wanted to be with God, with Source, the other side, where there was love and connection and support that I did not feel on this third dimensional planet. I'm here to show you the way home. That has been the message that I have received my whole life, and I've never understood that. And I'm beginning to see that probably a little more clearly now. I'm also understanding that we are in this huge transformational shift globally, and every single one of us are feeling it. Each and every single one of us need to remember who we are. It is that critical of a time that we are in. It's time to go in and do that hard work and do the shadow work. We feel out of alignment, and we feel like, you know, everybody else has got this really cool, magnificent life, but what you're not realizing is they have a mask on. I also realized during this, yesterday, a lot of it culminated. Today, the answer is actually formulated, was the disillusionment that I felt, because I'm thinking I'm making right choices, I'm making the good choices, being based on my alignment, my core values, and all of that. But I'm also still finding that there's a lot of people in wolf's, you know, the sheep in wolf's clothing, so to speak, or the wolf in sheep's clothing, whatever that is, that there are still a lot of people that are out there, and they've conned me into believing that they really gave a crap about me and they were interested, but it really came down to it's all about money. And I've learned that I have to take that to the next level of, you know, this could be karmic, because it could be. It could be me learning to rise above a little bit more. It could mean that I need to learn forgiveness more. And I also have to realize that they are not my source or whatever. So there's a lot of times when things are happening to us that we don't understand. And we think, you know, they're doing it to me, but they're not doing it to me. And that's the one thing I do know is nobody did this to me. I allowed it to happen. I went in there with my eyes open. I was fully conscious, fully present when I made the decision. What I was upset about was that I felt like I got conned, like I missed something, like I really misread somebody. So my question that I have at this point is, okay, that means I need to go a little bit deeper, look at what is it that I didn't see within myself that I allowed somebody's rhetoric to convince me otherwise. I'm also finding that a lot of people are selling things that they're not ready to sell, but they're selling it as if they are ready to sell it. And so there's this whole thing that, you know, we need to have our eyes open. And the only way you're going to get your eyes open is that you really know who you are, what you need, what you think you need, you know, and if you don't know, ask somebody, you know, to fill in what you're might be blinded to. Well, we're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break. Welcome back, everyone, to the Journey of an Awakening Spirit. This is Kathleen Flanagan, your host, and we're streaming on the Bold Brave TV network. So before the commercial break, I was talking about how people have masks on or they're misrepresenting. And sometimes it's really difficult to know that until whatever they say was going to happen didn't happen. And that's when you start finding out what the truth is. And then the question is how do you proceed with doing that? So what I want to do is give you a few ways on how you can bring yourself back into alignment, which then brings what I'm talking about home a little bit more. So you want to pause and reflect. And this is taking the time for the introspection, meditation, or journaling to understand what's causing the disconnection. Reconnect with your values. Identify what's truly important to you and whether your current path aligns with those values. Practice mindfulness. Being present in the moment can help you tune into your body and mind, allowing you to identify areas of imbalance. Set boundaries. Learn to say no to things that drain your energy or pull you away from your purpose. Listen to your intuition. Trust your gut feelings and let them guide your decisions. Engage in activities that inspire you. Find what brings you joy and passion, whether it's creative pursuits, spending time in nature, or spiritual practices. And then seek guidance, whether through meditation, spiritual coaching, or therapy, reaching out for support can help you to realign. So last night when I was in this place, what I did is I decided to journal, because I know that journaling brings a lot of stuff out. We bring a lot of our things, our thoughts out in that we don't even know that we're thinking about or experiencing at that point. And so I did a brain dump, because sometimes my brain just hurts and I know it hurts because I'm doing too much. And then I talked to Sal and said, you know, do you ever notice if I'm feeling depressed? Because, you know, I just feel like I'm being ignored and, you know, I'm feeling sorry for myself. And, you know, and he said, no, not always. And he said that, and I told him what I was feeling and he said, well, I get it. And you got to get over it. and not in an insensitive way, because he said, I feel that and I just have to get over it, that it's, we don't have time to be depressed. And I get that. But I also understand that we need to understand what that, those, what's coming up for us in those emotions. There is, because something triggered you. Something triggered me. And I was going back and reflecting, and I'm thinking, okay, well, look at where I've been since February of this year. I have grown immensely. And I mean immensely. And I'm sitting here going, well, I'm not seeing results. I'm not making money. I'm not this. I'm not that. But it really isn't about that. I think what it is I'm catching up with myself. Because, you know, we can move and move and move and move and move. But if we're not bringing all of us here because we're moving, 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 because we're being driven, because spirit has a way of driving us. And sometimes we feel like we don't have a say when we do. But part of us still doesn't say or stop because we're like, I can handle this. I can do this. But there does come a point where we have to stop and reflect. And spirit's going to make you do it if it makes you get sick, if it's going to give you body aches and pains, if it's going to get you into your head about something. You're going to stop and you're going to catch up with yourself and you're going to have to stop and look at what this is. So I'm feeling, okay, this is feeling like depression, but I don't feel depressed, but it has the look of a depression. And so then I went in and said, okay, what is this? I was stopped. I stopped yesterday and I realized that I like my isolation. I like being alone, but too much is too much. And that's what Sal was telling me. He says, you know, you don't leave. You're in the house all the time. He says, like, since February, you've been doing this and this and this and this and this. And I left you alone because I could see that whatever this was driving you. And I stepped back. not even thinking, how is he feeling here? It's all about me, because it's always about me. And I kind of like, I was, whoa. It made me stop and think about that for a moment of, wow, that really is true. It has been about me. And getting our future where we want it to be and what we want to do with our lives and that type of thing. And we're both working and striving to get to that place. I mean, we both are. He's doing it in his way and I'm doing it in mine. But I think what it was is that I just started feeling like, you like the cats more than me. You don't pay any attention to me. You know, the whole, oh my God, poor me. And it took a toll on me. And then being in these masterminds groups that I'm in, and then realizing I'm not using my voice enough, that I have so much more to say and I'm not saying it. And I'm like, but I'm not sure what to say or what that is or how that looks. And then the next thing that came up was my soul vision, that I'm stepping into my soul vision, because when I wrote it, it was outside of me. It didn't make sense to me. I could see it. I could understand it. I could get behind it, but it wasn't me yet. It didn't feel like it was part of me because it was so much bigger than me. And so through that visioning that I had done and has kept me motivated, I realized that I'm stepping into that vision, that bigness is becoming me. When I said that my higher self entered my body, it did enter my body. I am in a higher vibrational frequency. I am picking up on race consciousness because I can handle it, or it wouldn't have happened to me. That doesn't mean I always understand what's going on, but I do understand energy. And when something's moving and shifting, and I know Mercury's direct, but it doesn't feel direct. Everything about this last Mercury retrograde, it seems like everything is still chaotic. Miscommunications are still happening. People are having mechanical issues, technical issues, you name it. Everything that is a Mercury retrograde, it's like we are still in it. Those of us who are choosing to lead the way are in it because we've opened ourselves up more to receive more energy and more light. And because of that, that means the darkness within us is coming up because we're bringing more light in, so we can hold more light, so we can shine our light. There are things that I question what am I doing wrong that this channel is not growing the way I want to? Now, I am getting downloads. I am getting people watching. I'm getting all sorts of things. So it's not like it's not growing. My frustration is, what am I not doing? Because everybody, I keep getting these people that saying, well, you're not doing this and you're not doing this. And I go out and look at my competition and I'm doing far more than they are. Okay. I'm doing far more than they are. And I'm like, okay, they're lying to me. And I'm getting that there's not integrity here, that it's just about trying to get my money. And that they're preying on this element of myself of, you know, you got great content, you got this, you got that, but nothing's, but your viewership is down, or your watch time is down, or your subscribes are down, or whatever it is that they've decided is wrong. So last week, and this really blew my mind. So last week, I had probably the most watches of a video from last week than I've ever had on YouTube, on my channel. And I was like, wow, why did they stop at this point? And then, of course, in the morning, Spirit says, well, because you have this introduction, you need to take that out of the video that you put on your channel. And I'm like, okay, I can do that. And you need to do your own commercials. So I made 4 commercials. So to put into my videos. So, you know, there's a little bit more of bringing me out. What am I doing? Where am I going? Because what I discovered also, and what I was also told this morning, it's not about my courses. It's not about coaching. It's not about any of that. It's about, I have a message to deliver and I need to deliver it, whatever that is, however that looks. And that's what I'm going to do. That's why this alignment is so critical. And I know it's always been critical, because people always thought, because I actually talked to somebody a couple of weeks ago and they said, well, what's the difference between balance and alignment? It's the same thing. And I said, no, it's not. Alignment is being in tune with you. Being in balance is balancing your life, you know, that you have enough for self-care and work and play and recreation and things like that, where you're kind of more in a balance of and in the flow of your life. Alignment is being connected with source, being connected with you, being connected with that higher evolutionary process of you. What is your purpose? What is your mission for being here? You are living your purpose, believe it or not. You are living it. I know how to teach you and show you how you are living it. I know that. I know how to connect those dots. Because my whole life, it's like, why am I here? Why am I here? Why am I here? What's my purpose for being here? And I got the same message over and over and over and over again. But it made no sense to me, because it was foreign. I was out of alignment with that vision. I was off being disconnected, looking for the answers, but not going too deep, because God knows I didn't want to have that scary thing happen. I didn't want the monsters to come out that I was working so hard at stuffing down. I didn't want those feelings. I wanted people to stay away from me because I was terrified of people. I was afraid I would be hurt. The other thing that came up is, safety is my word, okay? I need to feel safe, and my job is to make you feel safe. And you know what I was shown? Safety is an illusion. So even though whatever happened out here in front of me with this physical body at a very young age, with the trauma, the abuse, the emotional, everything, I wasn't harmed. My body might have been harmed. My mind might have been harmed, but I wasn't harmed. The essence of me was not harmed. I was always safe, and I will always be safe. Somebody can come in and gun me down, and my body may die, but I won't die, and I'm still safe. So I'm also wrestling with that concept of safety and understanding the bigger picture of who I am, why I'm here, what it's like to bring heaven to earth, because we are doing that. I am around a group of people that heaven is on earth right now. It is. And the battle is with ourselves. When do you stop the lies? When do you stop your own self-abuse, your own torture? Because it comes down to when you're sick and tired of you being sick and tired of you. I know that in 2008, when I was asked to write these books, and what I thought the books were going to be about and what the books turned out to be were two totally different things. And I remember that I was so aware, not having the words today, then as I do today, the only thing I could say to myself is, I just want to be a better person. And what that meant is I wanted to be in alignment. I wanted to connect the inside and the outside of me. I wanted to reconnect with Source in a way that I have pushed it aside for so long because I felt abandoned and loved, unloved and unworthy. I did all of that to myself. Nobody did this to me but me. I might have had help in creating the limiting beliefs and the torturous thoughts that I created. I had help being removed from my body so I wouldn't incur whatever that was, so I could come back and be in my body and move in that direction. So I'm out of my body for 50 years of my life. Hello. Where I'm at, I probably would have been there 20, 30 years ago had I not left my body. But I was pulled out by spirit to protect me for whatever the reason is. I don't know that reason yet. I may know it, I may not. Does it matter? No, it doesn't. Because sometimes whatever happened to us, it doesn't matter. It's not about the story. It's about who are you today? What are you doing today for you? What are you doing today to connect to somebody else? What are you doing to be out of yourself and think that there's somebody else on this planet besides you? We're all guilty. I admit it. I was all about me yesterday. Oh, poor me. Sal doesn't love me. Sal likes the cats more than me. I mean, boo-hoo, what the hell? Where is this baby crap coming from? Okay, well, let's go research that. You know, what's it to do? It comes back from my undeserving, my unlovingness, what I released with my mother in the womb. Just because you release it and you see it doesn't mean that it's going to be just miraculously gone. It would be wonderful if it was, but it's not. Because we have built layer upon layer upon layer upon layer and lifetime upon lifetime upon lifetime. We built those thoughts. We created them. We gave evidence to it. We gave proof to it. We will die knowing we're so full of it. That time is over. The time is now. The world needs you now. We are in such a critical phase on so many levels, and the only way this world's going to shift and change and flip is when more and more of us come into alignment, when we remember who we are. This isn't easy work, but when you get on the other side of that darkness, it's like there's this whole world that you didn't even know existed, and then you get to recreate who you are. Like when I came out of the dark night of the soul, when after my mother had died and I had to face all of that stuff, it was like, who am I? What do I think? How do I feel? What do I believe in? I didn't know. I truly did not know anything about myself at that moment in time. Well, we're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break. Feeling overwhelmed? Take a moment to reconnect with your inner peace. Join Kathleen Flanagan's powerful de-stress meditation designed to help you release tension, calm your mind, and restore balance. Just a few minutes can transform your day. Visit KathleenMFlanagan.com and start your journey to tranquility today. Welcome back, everyone, to the Journey of an Awakening Spirit. This is Kathleen Flanagan, your host, and we're streaming on the Bold Brave TV network. So before the commercial break, I was talking about discovering who I was and what I thought and how I felt. And it was a long process. And I've had people say, why did it take you so long? And I think a lot of it is because I needed to know every step of the way. I needed to understand every emotion that I was feeling. I needed to understand and know the depth of me in a way that I didn't know. And I was trying things on and seeing what fit and what didn't fit and that type of thing. And it was like being a little baby, as the baby's like discovering his feet and is discovering its thumb and the flexibility and walking and crawling and screaming and biting and all those things. That's what happens when you come on the other side of the dark night of the soul. When you do the shadow work within you, you get, there's this whole new discovery of you. And the, what's so cool about in today's day and age is there's so many more people that have done the work, that there's a support system out there if you can find the people that you resonate with the most. I remember being told, you know, when the student's ready, the teacher will come. And the teacher never came for me because I was the teacher. And I've been told that I was the teacher. And I'm like, but I don't know anything. But I do know. I do know. I've always known. I just didn't let myself want to be known or know what I knew because I was afraid of my greatness. I was afraid of my own light. I was afraid of people thinking I was egotistical or arrogant or whatever. And you know what? Screw all of them. If you don't like me, who the hell cares? Because it's not about being liked as much as it's about your own self-respect. I mean, that's what self-care is about, is taking care of you. What do you think? How do you feel? Speak up for yourself. Set your boundaries. People don't like it. That's their problem. Because we live in a boundaryless society. And people think that it's okay to do whatever they want to do. They think it's okay to bully online or to bully or demean or diminish or body slam or whatever it is. Because they're so small and so hurting so badly deep inside that that's the only way they know how to feel good. And that's a crime, in my opinion. The murders, the rapes, all of that, this is all pain that somebody's feeling on the inside because they didn't get what they needed. They didn't get the love, the support, the connection, being heard, being valued. How many people are walking around wounded of not being seen, valued, and heard? God knows it was me. I mean, if you gave me this much of an intention, I would just do leaps and bounds of overdoing everything just so I could get a little bit more recognition. And yet, I wanted to be invisible because it was safe. Like I said, everything I did was about safety. I wanted to be seen. I wanted to be recognized. I wanted to be heard. I wanted to be respected. And I couldn't do that. And I am doing that now. In the David Bear organization, I'm always on the calls and we always start with wins. And I can't tell you how many people never share. My thing is that if I'm going to come in and play, I'm going to play all out. And when they asked for wins, I went deep inside to find, because how many times do we not recognize one iota of anything that we do that is good and valuable and meaningful? We do things all the time. You want to change the way you look at yourself. You want to change the way you look at the world. Change how you think. Recognize what you do. Because when you start recognizing that, you start changing the brain synapses. There is truth in the brain synapses of changing by getting out of the negative patterning and rewiring. Does it take time? Yeah, it takes a little bit of time. But the thing is that the more you recognize you and acknowledge you and take the time for you, is the more quickly you will move in your life. You know, people will say, Oh, yeah, I'm an overnight success after 20 years of hard work, because all people see is where you are today. They didn't see the 20 years before of working on your brain or working on your mind or working on yourself or all the work you did to bring out your books or your courses or whatever your teachings are. None of us are overnight successes. None of us are, because you haven't walked in our shoes. As bad as my life may have been, I know there's people that have a lot worse life than I ever could dream of. So I never think that I'm above or below anybody. Every single one of us have been in pain, trauma, suffering, abuse, neglect, whatever it is. And if it didn't come from somebody outside of us, we did it to ourselves. I know people that had the most amazing upbringings and they're a mess in their head. It doesn't matter. We all have to work through our stuff. I mean, yeah, it's like what Amber said a couple of weeks ago is, you know, she's got the big smile and the poppy flowers and everything's all happy, lovey-dovey, but she suffered in silence as a child. She struggled to get her business where she is. She struggled through the narcissistic behaviors of people in her life, being gaslighted, the whole thing. So just because she has this success doesn't mean she's above anyone else. Elon Musk, same thing. Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, all of them. We all have things to work on. The question is, are you going to do it in the limelight? Are you going to do it in the safety of your home? Are you going to have support around you? Or are you going to do it all by yourself? Or are you going to find a therapist? Doesn't matter. As long as you're doing something to help yourself. There's no excuse to hold on to your anger, your bitterness, your resentments, your frustration. There's no reason to do that. Let the emotion out. I mean, like today, I mean, I got on this call and I started talking and I just started bawling. I'm like, oh my God, where did this emotion come from? I'm releasing. Tears can be a good thing. Sharing is a good thing. We have to get rid of that pain. Scream in a pillow. You know what I mean? I used to do that all the time. My thing was vacuuming. Let's vacuum. And I'm like, rah, 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 and I got done. My house was clean and I felt great. We have to let that anger out. We have to let the angst out. We have to let that frustration out. You're the only one who knows why it's there. You can talk about it, but that doesn't mean you're the only one who knows. And you have to do that self-reflection. That's what part of being in alignment is. You start understanding, you start listening to your higher self. You start trusting you, because every single one of us has an intuitive ability. We're just choosing not to listen to it or not choosing to use it. Mine's evolving in a way that sometimes I just get really frustrated because I'd rather just have them tell me everything to do. But that's not what I want either. I mean, Ariel told me that years ago. She said, well, you like to put things together. You know, you like to do this, like, how does this work? And how does this work? And how does this come together? And how do I blend it all together to make it cohesive? I hate it. And I love it at the same time, because it takes time. I'm not somebody who walks in a room and says, oh, I know what this room's going to look like. Oh, no, I do little things at a time. I mean, my last house was the same thing. Okay, let's paint the walls first. Okay, let's get some carpet. Okay, let's change out the windows. Oh, I think I want to do a surround around my fireplace. Oh, let's update the doors. Oh, let's do the bathrooms. And it was like piece by piece by piece by piece I did the renovations on my home. When it was done, it was absolutely beautiful. I was so impressed with myself, I didn't even know it was me who created that. But that's how I do things. I take pieces and it's like, oh, and here comes this idea and then this idea. Again, it's taking that first step. We talked about that in the group this morning. We may not know how to get to our destination, but we know the first step. Once we take the first step, the second one will show. We take the third step, spirit starts coming towards us. We keep taking whatever step we can take to move into that next into that next place that we need to go. Spirit comes to us. Things come to us. It flows, but you have to be connected to your inner self. Your connection, your paying attention, your observation, and sometimes sitting and waiting can suck. You know, I decided I'm in the pregnant pause. Long time since I've used that term, the pregnant pause. That means I'm ready to birth something, but it's that there's that perfect timing. You don't want to go too soon and you don't want to go too late. It's that pause that you just wait for that moment to show up. And the only way you know when that moment is here is when you stop and you just feel your way through it. If you don't like sitting in quietness and solitude, go out and work in your garden. You know, paint a room. Do something different. That's what I do. Sometimes me, it's walking. You know, I haven't been able to dance in a while. But dancing is another thing that used to bring so much joy to me, is ballroom dancing. I loved it because it was expressive. I could be who I was. I could show the world a totally different side of me. And I was happy. And I was taking care of myself. And that's what we all need to do. What is it that makes your heart sing and do that? We're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break. Are you ready to step into your true potential? Kathleen Flanagan's Get Into Alignment session helps you break through blocks, balance your energy, and align with your highest self. Experience clarity, purpose, and flow like never before. Visit KathleenMFlanagan.com and unlock the power of living in alignment today. Welcome back, everyone, to the Journey of an Awakening Spirit. This is Kathleen Flanagan, your host, and we're streaming on the Bold Brave TV network. By following and by paying attention to the steps that I outlined, you're going to realign with your true self, and you'll likely experience the greater sense of peace, flow, and purpose in your life. And I know that it's true. What I also know too is when we're in an emotion, and it's only going to be 90 seconds, just be with that for 90 seconds. When that intensity of emotion comes up where it just feels like it's gripping you in a way. Because when I got off the call today, I felt like I don't know what to do. I don't even know why I'm crying. I don't know this. And I'm like, I got to get like ready for the show. I have to do this. And you know, it was like, just felt, and then it was like, Kath, sit down and just be. And let the emotion flow through you. Don't hold on to it. Just let it pass. 90 seconds is all it takes. How many of us give ourselves 90 seconds to just feel an emotion and watch it walk away? We don't. We hold on to it. We make a story about it. We make a drama about it. You know, we live our life around it, and we don't have to do any of that. The freedom is letting things go. It's letting it right off your back. I'm a very deeply emotional person, and I feel everything. I understand energies. I understand frequencies. I have spent my entire life learning them and understanding them. I'm in an area in my life right now that I don't know where I am energetically. All I know is that my higher self came in and she's taking me higher. That's an emotional toll sometimes on us because I'm navigating waters I don't know. I'm learning tools that I don't know what I know yet. That's the beauty of this. That's the beauty of I came down here to experience life, and by golly, that's exactly what I've done in this lifetime, is experience it. When I leave, I will know that I've accomplished everything that I wanted to, because there's only one thing left in my life to accomplish. And if I make it, fine. If not, I don't care about that either. Because what I'm really here to do is I'm here to serve. I'm here to help the planet. I'm here to help humanity. When Amber talk about that entrepreneurs are givers. All we do is give, and we never receive anything back. Well, that's part of the alignment process too, is learning to receive. That's why the soul vision is so important, because it's the bigger vision that drives us. Money will never drive us. At least it's never driven me. Yeah, do I want things? Yeah. Do I want all this other stuff? Yeah. Do I need it? No. Does it matter? No. All it is just an outward expression of what I'm capable of doing, of how much energy I can hold. Because money is nothing more than an energy. You want $1 million, then you better get your energy up, because $1 million has a lot of energy behind it. If you're used to making $50,000, go up to $100,000 and watch your life change. It's an energy pattern. And then the question is, can you hold it? Once you get there, can you hold it? You're never going to hold it if you don't start releasing whatever's holding you back. All this is coming from my truth. This is all of my observations of my life, of what I'm doing. I'm obviously not ready to have certain things in my life yet, or I would have them. But I'm okay with it, because what I realize is that it comes from within. Everything that needs to happen and change in our world right now comes from within us. It's not on the outside. We can sit there and say, well, my bank account doesn't have $1 million in it. What's wrong with me? Well, because you're not ready for $1 million. Your energy's not there. What have you done to change this so $1 million can come to you? You give. You give value. You give more of who you are. You bring you to the table. You have something somebody wants. It's not your program. It's not a course. They want you. They want your light. And that's a hard one to accept too, because now it's not, well, they don't like my course. You've got that shield up. Again, you're protected. Okay? The illusion of safety. When you bring your heart to the table, and you bring all of you to the table, and you are in total, utter vulnerability, you tell me how your life changes at that moment. Because your life will change at that moment. And if you think it's easy, try it. Well, I want to thank all of you guys today for being on the show. I hope I brought some value to you. I also, if you have any questions or you want to learn more about what I talked about today, feel free to reach out to me at bravetv@kathleenmflanagan.com. If you like what you saw, or if you found any value, please like and subscribe to the show, and even send the link to friends and family if you think that they'll find some value out of this. My books, Dancing Souls, The Dark Night of the Soul, and Awakened are available on Amazon.com and KathleenMFlanagan.com. You want to learn more about me, read the books. It's the story of my life at that up until that point. And, you know, there's another book coming. That's all I know. I don't know what it looks like yet, but it's coming. I also invite you to go to KathleenMFlanagan.com, and I am offering guidance. Alignment guidance. So if you're interested, just go there and you can sign up for a session to get back into alignment. I also have a 3-minute de-stress meditation that is there absolutely free to help bring you back into alignment as well, because it's balancing your chakras and it'll help bring some peace and tranquility to your life. That's all I have for today. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you guys next week, Tuesday at 4 p.m. And from my heart to yours, I hope you have a fabulous week.